G'day, Bergs, and I am back again with the excellent Boss 40-watt Nextone amp. I had a preview of this in Sydney about 6 months ago, and I was surrounded by studio people and Roland staff, but now I've got it in the privacy of my own tiny weeny little studio, so I'm able to put it to the test, and it is pretty darn good. This is a mid-priced amp. It offers four different types of power amp settings. You've got two channels, a clean and a lead, both with their own boost control, which you can see here. You can switch it off with your finger, or you can use a foot switch. There are foot switch facilities on the rear of the amp. But it also has an editor that you can get in there and modify all of the settings with, including some of the effects. And I'll show you that in another video. But today I just want to kind of touch on the clean tones and how it interacts with some standard pedals, which I have at my feet. You'll see from your right, the 69 Vibe, which is Sean Klinger's excellent Univibe clone, probably the best on the market, I think. Then I've got a Dazatronyx Professional Drive, which is a Tube Screamer by Darren, and a Sick-As Overdrive by Bondi Effects, and a Specular Tempus Delay Reverb by GFI Systems. On the amp itself, you'll also find delay and reverb settings here, and you can just turn those down or up according to your tastes, and you can actually get in there in the editor and edit those as well. You'll notice about 2 seconds of delay time here, so I'm just going to switch that off. This is a Vola guitar. I love it. It's called the Vola Oz. So there's our clean channel. You've got a volume control here. You've got three band EQ, bass, middle, and treble. There's also a tone switch here, which will make things a little more, a little crisper. And then you've got delay and reverb with tap tempo on the reverb. Tap tempo on the delay, I meant to say before, and you can turn the reverb up and down. And a presence and a master control, followed by this excellent power amp simulation here. So you've got 6V6. Back the reverb off a bit, and it feels nice and spongy like a 6V6 amp would. 6L6 for something a little higher output, you know, we're talking boogies, twins, that sort of thing. We've got EL84. And then we've got EL34. And they all have slightly different tonal characteristics that you can get in and actually edit in the editor. Again, I'll show you that in another video. If we switch over here with the channel select switch, we go to the lead channel. And again, you can tailor that sound with the EQ control here, turn the gain up or down and the volume up or down. And it has plenty of volume. But if I kick in the Tube Screamer here, or the Professional Drive as Darren calls it, or the Sick As, you can hear that it takes pedals pretty well. If I go back to the clean channel again, hit the Tube Screamer, or before the sick as, which has got more gain. And maybe the vibe in front of it. You can hear that it takes pedals very, very well. How does it go with a bit of delay? Beautifully. So there it is, a quick look at the 40 watt Nextone amp. It sounds good, it's got plenty of volume, it's very light because it's solid state. It uses tube logic to pull these, you know, amazing sounds that you can edit in the next video. And, you know, it's just good value for money, I think. See you soon.